In software development, what is a framework and why is it useful? Let's talk about that in this video. Welcome back. My name is Tim Buchalka with another programming tip of the day. And the question again was, what is a framework in programming terms and why is it useful? Well, consider a building. You probably understand a physical building. It's got framework and that's the essential supporting structure of that building. So in programming terms, think of a framework as some software that's already been developed and is used to help you create your own application. So it's basically reusable code that provides specific functionality that you can use in your programs. So basically the intention of a framework is to avoid you needing to reinvent the wheel. Now, an example of a framework in Java is the Java Collections Framework. Now, consider that, or imagine a scenario where you actually need to sort some names. You've got a list of names and you're writing in Java and you want to figure out how do I actually sort those into alphabetical order. Now, you could do it manually. You'd have to figure out how to write the sorting code, how to, you know, basically come up with a way to sort alphabetically. And after that, you'd have to find a way to basically write it in such a way that it was very efficient. And basically, in practical terms, it wouldn't be an efficient use of your time. And the reason for that is there's framework out there, there's code out there that will already write that or already perform that functionality, in this case, sorting for you. So the Java Collections Framework, which I talked about, that provides a sort method, a very easy method, and it's basically one line of code that you call, which will sort, in this case, a list of names. But whatever the scenario was, it'll sort them efficiently. So that's basically allowing you to focusing on or to focus on your program and not to worry about the low-level stuff. Now, the other thing to keep in mind is that this code, this framework, has probably been worked on by a number of different programmers. It's been tested, it's been optimized, so it's probably going to be a lot more efficient code-wise than you could produce yourself. Certainly, it would probably take you any programmer a long time to basically come up to the level of the code in some of these frameworks, and the Java Collections frameworks is an example of that. So you wouldn't want to be doing that type of code yourself. You want to be focusing on the high-level software, high-level functionality of your software, and not worrying about this low-level stuff. And keep in mind that a good programmer not only knows the basic syntax of a programming language, but they also know one or more frameworks as well. So in Java terms, learning the Java Collections framework would be a great thing to add to your resume, and it also makes you a more productive programmer as well. Alrighty, so I hope that helped. If you've got any questions, feel free to leave a comment and I'll get back to you. If you're ready to look at the next tip, click on up here and you can check that out. If you're interested in coding specific programming videos, click on the link in the bottom left-hand corner. Consider subscribing by clicking on the link up here and I'll see you soon.